It's not like I had never seen a dead body. It's not even like I had not had the experience of losing someone I loved, someone I was close to. I had. My father suffered for years, and when I was in my 20s, he died, and I was there with him. We walked together to the other side, holding hands. So it's not like I had not had an extraordinary experience with death. But this was different. I sat next to her bed, making promises that we both knew I would not be able to keep. But I made them anyway, because I would say anything to bring her to the other side, to help save her from drowning in that pain. I would promise almost anything. Before this, she was magnificent, striking, like an Egyptian goddess. She had black hair, dark eyes, dark golden skin. And she could do anything. I mean, she was so creative. She could do things like collect walnut skins and make dyes and dye the wool that she carded and spun herself, and then she wove these magnificent works of art. She knew the secrets of the body. She understood what the body would respond to with movement and stretching and twirling. She knew about vitamins and minerals and herbs before it was popular, ordinary, every day like it is now. Oh, if she were alive now, she would be 70 some years old. When we met, I was 17, and we were dancers. We both loved movement. And like the ocean, I was at high tide, and she was ebbing at low tide. But she had this amazing energy radiating from her. I was just drawn to her. She was a culture creative before her time. We became very close friends. My mother was threatened by my love of my friend Amo. Amo was everything that my mother was not. She was forceful, strong-willed, dynamic. She explored the occult. She was an astrologer. She was an astral traveler. She was opinionated, bitchy, eccentric, exciting, stimulating, sexy. And you know, my mother didn't need to worry about Amo replacing her, because Amo was my friend, my mentor, my guide. And I guided her. I helped her navigate the waterways of the heart, because Amo, even though her name means love, had forgotten and had alienated practically everyone and anyone who had ever loved her, even her own daughter. But we shared a beautiful friendship until my mid-30s. And then she got sick. Cancer. It was unbelievable. I mean, here was a woman that knew how to take care of herself. And she took great care of herself, and she taught other people how to take care of themselves, and she had cancer. And the doctors opened her up to cut it out, but it was everywhere inside. So they closed her up, and she decided not to get chemo. She went to Mexico so she could have some alternative healing, and I stayed here. in Portland with my husband and my little children, and I went to my job every day. And we would write and correspond, and a couple of times we talked on the telephone, and her condition improved. I think it was because there at that place, they would hug her all the time. And the human touch is so healing. When she came home, she was more herself than she had been in months. But that didn't last long. I would go over every day to help her. You know, bring her food, do her laundry, wash her kitchen floor, help take care of her 42 finches, her 5 cats, her 2 dogs, the raccoons and the feral cats that she fed, and her giant parrot, Rosie, that I was really afraid of. Eventually, it all came to this day, this moment where I sat next to Amo's bed, making promises that I knew I could not keep. It was just Amo and I in that room. There were other people in the house who loved her, but at that moment, it was just the two of us. And her breathing grew weaker and weaker. And then there was a gurgle, and it was her last breath. And I felt relieved and so terribly sad. And then something extraordinary happened. I saw Amo leave her body. It was her shadow self. Maybe it was her spirit. Maybe it was her soul. I don't know. But I could not take my eyes off of this thing coming out of her body. It was dark, but not black. And it seemed to have a substance. It was like a mist. It reminded me of a cloud that was heavy with rain. Gray, blue, and it was moving. Moving up into the air, into that space over the bed. And then it faded away. And I looked back at Amo, at her body, but she was gone. And I felt so very alone. That was extraordinary to see that, you know, really see that with my eyes. I saw that. That was extraordinary. And I was struck not by how amazing her departure was, no. I was struck by the extraordinary journey that we had shared together. And I realized that now I had to go on without her. Te amo.